This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, students. Last class, I explained some concept in hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. In the today's class also, I will revise that concept. Then I will explain the further concepts in hydraulic jump. So coming to this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. Already we started this hydraulic jump. We discussed this hydraulic jump at the bottom of the spillway and also at the bottom of the sluice gate. We know that the hydraulic jump is formed when the supercritical water flow changes to subcritical water flow. So in the open channel, either at the bottom of the spillway or at the bottom of the sluice gate, when the water flow in the supercritical condition changes to the water flow in subcritical condition, during that transformation we have this phenomena of hydraulic jump. We discussed in the previous classes the hydraulic jump by using Newton's second law of motion. We consider the water flow before the hydraulic jump, section 1. We consider the water flow after the hydraulic jump, section 2. By using Newton's second law of motion, we proved that between the section 1 and section 2 in the hydraulic jump, the specific force is constant. That is, F1 is equal to F2. The specific force of water flow before the hydraulic jump is equal to the specific force of water flow after the hydraulic jump. We also discussed in the previous classes, before the hydraulic jump, the depth of flow is Y1. After the hydraulic jump, the depth of water flow is Y2. In hydraulic jump, Y1 is called initial depth. Y2 is called sequent depth. At depth Y1 and depth Y2, the specific force is constant. F1 is equal to F2. So we call the two depths Y1 and Y2 in hydraulic jump as the conjugate two depths. So please understand this hydraulic jump clearly. For your examination point of view, it is important. Then I am going to explain the hydraulic jump in the rectangular open channel. Sometimes we can consider the river as a rectangular open channel, and the artificial channels are also sometimes the rectangular channels. So I am going to explain the hydraulic jump in the rectangular channels. It may be either the river or the artificial channel. So coming to this hydraulic jump in rectangular channels, check this diagram. I change the slide. Please check your cell phones and look at the diagram in the cell phones. In the diagram, we have the hydraulic jump, that is the top. We consider this hydraulic jump is formed in the rectangular channel. We consider this hydraulic jump formed in the rectangular channel, either at the bottom of the spillway or at the bottom of the sluice gate. We consider this hydraulic jump formed in the rectangular channel. Before the hydraulic jump, the water flow is supercritical condition. At supercritical condition, Y1 is the depth of water flow. This is called initial depth. After the hydraulic jump, the water flow is in subcritical condition. At subcritical condition, the depth of water flow is Y2. Y2 is called sequent depth. But we know that in hydraulic jump, at depth Y1, sorry, depth Y2, the specific force is constant. F1 is equal to F2. So we call these two depths Y1, Y2 as the conjugate two depths. The depth Y1, depth Y2 having the same specific force are known as conjugate two depths. Now coming to this rectangular channel. This is the section 1 before the hydraulic jump. This is the section 2 after the hydraulic jump. Then at section 1, the flow is supercritical condition. Depth of flow at section 1 is y1. Depth of flow at section 1 is y1. Velocity of flow at section 1 is v1. Discharge of water flow is q. This is the hydrostatic pressure at section 1. This hydrostatic pressure is due to the weight of water. At the top, weight of water is 0. At the bottom, we have the weight of water. Since from top to bottom, the weight of water increasing, from top to bottom, the weight of water increasing, we have this hydrostatic pressure at section 1. Because of this hydrostatic pressure at section 1, the hydrostatic force is F1. So please don't confuse this F1. This is the hydrostatic force at section 1. Coming to section 2, after the hydraulic jump, at section 2, the depth of water flow is y2. y2 is called sequent depth. At section 2, velocity of water flow is v2. And at section 2, this is the hydrostatic pressure distribution. Take F2 is the hydrostatic force at section 2. And we have the weight of water component W sin theta, and also the friction force. Here we consider the channel as a rectangular channel. So this is the rectangular channel at section 1. The rectangular channel at section 1 having the bottom width B. At section 1, depth of flow is y1. Since the channel is rectangle, the center of gravity of channel from this top is at half of the depth, y1 by 2. That is Z1 bar. So at section 1, this is the rectangular channel of bottom width B, depth of flow y1, and from the top, the distance of the center of gravity of channel at section 1 is y1 by 2, that is Z1 bar. Then at section 2 also, the channel is rectangle at section 2. V is the bottom width. At section 2, depth of flow is y2. So the center of gravity of the channel at section 2 is at half of the depth, y2 by 2, that is z2 bar. So here we consider this hydraulic jump formed in the rectangular channel. We know that in the hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to specific force at section 2. In hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to specific force at section 2. Already I explained it. In open channels, the specific force F is equal to Q square by ZA plus A into Z bar. That is the specific force. We know that in hydraulic jump, the specific force before the hydraulic jump, that is at section 1, is equal to the specific force at section 2 after the hydraulic jump. Apply that principle in this rectangular channel. So we are going to discuss this hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel by considering at section 1, the specific force F1 is equal to the specific force at section 2 F2. So I am going to explain this rectangular channel hydraulic jump from that concept. We know that at section 1, before the hydraulic jump, the width of the rectangular channel is B, depth of flow is Y1. This is the width of the rectangular channel at section 1. Y1 is the depth of water flow at section 1. So the wetted area of the channel at section 1, since it is rectangle, the wetted area is equal to width B into depth of flow y1. So at section 1, the wetted area of channel is B into y1. and at section 2 the wetted area. At section 2 the width of the rectangular channel is b, the depth of flow is y2. So at section 2 the wetted area b into y2, and at section 1 from the top the distance of the center of gravity is half of the depth y1 by 2, that is z1 bar. And at section 2 from the top the distance of the center of gravity is y2 by 2, that is z2 bar. Since the channel is rectangular channel, we consider q is the discharge of water flow in the rectangular channel, b is the width of the rectangular channel, so q by b is called the discharge per unit width small q. So in this discussion q is the discharge of water flow from section 1 to section 2, b is the width of the rectangular channel, so q by b is called the discharge of water flow per unit width. We know that in hydraulic jump f1 is equal to f2. So f1, what is f1? 2 square by ZA, ZA1 plus A1 into Z1 bar. Already I explained in the previous classes, in hydraulic jump, the specific force F1 at section 1 is equal to specific force F2 at section 2. We know that in open channels, the specific force F is equal to Q square by ZA plus AZ bar. So at section 1, specific force F1 is equal to Q square by ZA1 plus A1 into Z1 bar. Here the channel is rectangular channel. So the wetted area A1 is equal to B into Y1. Z1 bar is equal to Y1 by 2. Substitute that in the left hand side. Q square by ZA1 plus A1 Z1 bar. In this rectangular channel, A1, B into Y1, Z1 bar, Y1 by 2. So, this left hand side, the specific force F1. F1 is equal to Q square by Z into A1. A1 is B into Y1 plus A1, B into Y1 into Z1 bar, Y1 by 2 is equal to F2. F2 is the specific force in section 2. So that F2 specific force at section 2 is Q square by Z into A2. That A2 wetted area is B into Y2 plus A2 B into Y2 into Z2 bar Y2 by 2. So here I applied the hydraulic jump specific force relation. In hydraulic jump, the specific force F1 is equal to specific force F2. So in that F1, A1 is equal to B into Y1, Z1 bar is equal to Y1 by 2, A2 is equal to B into Y2, Z2 bar is equal to Y2 by 2. Then simplify this equation. Bring these discharge terms. We have two discharge terms here. Bring these two discharge terms on one side, remaining terms on the other side. So bring this Q square by Z into BY2 to the left side and bring this term to the right side. This equation changes as Q square by Z into BY1 minus, bring this term to the left side. So it is a Q square by Z B into Y2 is equal to, bring this term to the right side. It is a BY2 into Y2 by 2 minus BY1 into Y1 by 2. So just bring this Q square term in this right hand side to the left side and bring this term on the left side to the right side. You will get this equation. Then in this equation, left side, in this equation, Q square by Z into B is common. So take this equation, Q square by Z into B is common. Take that Q square by Z into B common in the two terms. So Q square by Z into B into 1 by Y1 minus 1 by Y2. That is this left hand side is equal to on the right side, this b by 2 is common. B by 2 is common. Take it outside. B by 2 into the first term. Y2 into y2, y2 square minus y1 into y1, y1 square. So in this equation, on the left side, take q square by z into b common. So it is a q square by z into b into 1 by y1 minus 1 by y2 is equal to, on the right side, take this b by 2 common. So it is b by 2 into y2 square minus y1 square. Then in this equation, bring this b to the left side. Here it is in the numerator. Bring this b to the left side, it comes to the denominator. So on the left side, b into b becomes as b square. So bring this b to the left side, the equation changes as q square by z into b square. So just bring that b from right side to left side, the previous equation changes as q square by z into b square into 1 by y1 minus 1 by y2 is equal to half into y2 square minus y1 square. So please follow this modifications carefully. We are discussing hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. We applied the condition F1 is equal to F2. F1 specific force at section 1 before the hydraulic jump is equal to F2 specific force at section 2 after the hydraulic jump. So we applied that condition. F1 is equal to F2. In that we substitute the rectangular channel values. A1 is equal to B into Y1. Z1 bar is equal to Y1 by 2. A2 is equal to B into Y2. Z2 bar is equal to Y2 by 2. We substitute that relations in that equation and we are going to simplify that equation. Then due to simplification, finally we got this relation. Q square by Z into B square into 1 by Y1 minus 1 by y2 is equal to half into y2 square minus y1 square. Then in the left side, take this y1, y2 as LCM on the left side. So take this y1, y2 as LCM. So this term 1 by y1 minus 1 by y2 becomes as, this is that modification. Take this y1, y2 as LCM. So this left hand side becomes as q square. You know that capital Q by B is small q. Capital Q by B is small q. Discharge per unit width. So Q square by B square. Capital Q square by B square is small q square. So small q square by Z into, take this Y1, Y2 as LCM. So it is Y1, Y2 into, in the numerator, it is Y2 minus Y1. So in this left hand side, capital Q square by capital B square is small q square. Because Q by B is small q. Capital Q by capital B is the discharge per unit width. So it is small q. Then in that left hand side, take Y1, Y2 as LCM. If I take Y1, Y2 as LCM in the left hand side, that left hand side equation becomes as y2 minus y1 divided by y1 y2. So understand this modification please. So take this y1 y2 LCM in the left side. Then in the numerator you will get y2 minus y1 is equal to, coming to the right hand side, half into this equation a square minus b square form. A square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So separate this term y2 square minus y1 square as y2 plus y1 into y2 minus y1. This is from this previous equation. So check this equation. We can cancel this y1 minus y2 on both sides. So cancel this y1 minus y2 on both sides. Then this equation becomes as, this equation becomes as q square by z into 1 by y1 y2 because y2 minus y1 is cancel on both sides. So 1 by y2 y1 y2 is equal to half into on the right side we have y2 plus y1. So cancel this y2 minus y1 on both sides. You will get this equation q square by z into 1 by y1 y2 is equal to half into y1 plus y2. Then bring this 2. Bring this 2 to the right left side and y1 y2 to the right side. In this equation, bring this 2 to the left side, y1 y2 to the right side. This equation becomes as 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. So bring this y1 y2 to the right side and this 2 to the left side. Then observe this equation. In this equation, 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. Expand this right hand side. Expand this right hand side. You will get from this equation this another equation. 2q square by z is equal to expand this right hand side. Y2 into y2, y2 square. So the first term is y1 into y2 square plus the second term is y1 into y1, y1 square into y2. So from this equation, expand this right hand side, you will get this equation. 2q square by z is equal to y1 into y2 square plus y2 into y1 square. So for rectangular channel, when the hydraulic jump is formed in the rectangular channel, from the specific force relation F1 is equal to F2, we got that equation 2. So in the rectangular open channel during the hydraulic jump, the relation between the depth y1, depth y2 is 2q square by z is equal to y1 into y2 square plus y2 into y1 square. This is the equation 2 for hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. So please read this equations on the cell phone screens. Go through these equations on the cell phone screens and understand about this derivation of equation 2. We call this equation 2 as the momentum equation. We call this equation 2 as the momentum equation because we got this equation 2 from the specific force condition F1 is equal to F2. We got that specific force condition F1 is equal to F2 from Newton's second law. So we call this equation 2 as the momentum equation for the hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. We have the numerical problems also in this equation 2. So this equation 2 is called the momentum equation for the hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. So go through these steps on the cell phones and understand this derivation of equation 2. If you have any doubts up to this derivation of equation 2, you please discuss with me. Up to that derivation of equation 2, if you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. Yesterday, I explained this hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. It is an important concept in unit 2. So I am revising this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel even in the today's class also. So we consider the hydraulic jump formed in the rectangular channel. Before the hydraulic jump, depth of flow is y1, channel bottom width is b. After the hydraulic jump, depth of flow is y2, channel bottom is b. Then we apply the specific force condition in that hydraulic jump F1 is equal to F2. From that condition, F1 is equal to F2, we got the equation 2. Check that equation 2. The equation 2 is having y1 square. Equation 2 is having y1. Equation 2 is having 2q square by z. Small q is constant. If the discharge capital Q, channel bottom V are constant, small q is also constant. So this 2q square by z is constant. So check this equation 2. The equation 2 has y1 square. Equation 2 has y1. Equation 2 has the constant 2q square by z. So this equation 2 is a quadratic equation in terms of y1 square. Like ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. We call that as quadratic equation of x. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is the quadratic equation of x. The equation 2 has y1 square. Equation 2, check this equation 2. It has y1 square. It has y1. It has the constant c, 2q square by z. So we can consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y1. Similarly, equation 2 has y2 square. Equation 2 has y2. Equation 2 has the constant 2q square by z. So this equation 2 is also the quadratic equation in terms of the depth y2, because it has y2 square, y2, and also the constant. So observe this equation 2. The equation 2 is the quadratic equation in terms of depth y1, because it has y1 square, y1, and the constant 2q square by z. So the equation 2 is a quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y1. The equation 2 is also the quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y2, because it has y2 square, y1, and the constant. So we can consider this equation 2 as the quadratic equation either in terms of depth of flow y1 or in terms of depth of flow y2, because we have y2 y1 square, y1, and constant 2q square by z. We also have y2 square, y2, and the constant 2q square by z. So we can consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation either in terms of depth of flow y1 or in terms of depth of flow y2. In both ways, you can consider that equation 2 as the quadratic equation. So that equation 2 can be considered as the quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y1 and also in terms of depth of flow y2. Now, if I consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y2, that is, I consider y2 square, y1, and the constant. You know that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 has one solution. That is, x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. That is the solution of x for the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Now, first I consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of y2 square. So y2 square into y1. Take this y1 as a. y2 square into y1. y1 is a. Plus y2 into y1 square. Take this y1 square as b. So check this carefully. Y2 square into y1. Take this y1 as a. Plus y2 into y1 square. Take this y1 square as b. So the right hand side, a into y2 square plus b into y2. Bring this 2q square by to the right side. It becomes minus 2q square by z, that is c. Bring this 2q square by z to the right side. It is minus 2q square by z. Take that as c. So this equation 2 is a into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c. That c is minus 2q square by z equal to 0. So first I consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of the depth of flow y2. So this quadratic equation is a, that a is y1, a into y2 square plus b, that b is y1 square, b into y2 plus c, that c is 2q square by z minus 2q square by z equal to 0. So consider this equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of the depth of flow y2. We know that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 as the solution. X is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Apply that solution here. You will get y2 is equal to the depth y2 from the quadratic equation of equation 2. A into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0. I will get this depth y2 solution. This is that equation. I got this solution of depth y2 from the quadratic equation solution. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 as the solution. X is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Apply that equation here. You will get this y2 is equal to, y2 is equal to minus y1 by 2 plus root of y1 by 2 whole square, that is b square plus 4ac, that is 2q square by z into y1. So I got this equation 3 from the mathematics. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 has one solution. X is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. From that condition, I got that y2. So I consider this equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of y2 square. I consider first the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of y2 square. So this y1 is a, y1 square is b, and this minus 2q square. So this equation 2 becomes as a into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0. Then the equation has the solution of y2. Y2 is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. From that I got this equation. Y2 is equal to minus y1 by 2 plus root of y1 by 2 whole square plus 2q square by zy1. So the equation 2 is considered as quadratic equation in terms of the depth y2. Then from that we got this equation 3. That is x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. From that you got this equation 3. We know that the equation 2 is also the quadratic equation in terms of the depth y1. So check that carefully. Now I am going to consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y1 square, y1. So here y2 is a. So it is a into y1 square plus, take this y2 square as b. So it is b into y1. Take this 2q square by z to the right side. It is minus 2q square by z, that is c. So the equation 2 is considered as quadratic equation in terms of y1. So it is a into y1 square plus b into y1 plus c equal to 0. Then I can write the solution of depth y1, because it is the quadratic equation in y1. it is a into y1 square plus b into y1 plus c equal to 0. So this y1 is equal to minus b. What is that b? y2 square minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4a. What is a? y2. What is c? 2q square by z divided by 2a. So by considering this equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of the depth y1, I got the equation of depth y1 here. Y1 is equal to minus y2 by 2 plus root of y2 by 2 whole square plus 2q square by zy2. From equation 2, we got this equation 3. From equation 2, we got this equation 3 by considering the equation 2 as a quadratic equation in terms of depth y2. Similarly, from equation 2, we got equation 4 by considering the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of the depth of flow y1. So from equation 2, I got equation 3 and equation 4. Because the equation 2 is a quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y1 and also in terms of depth of flow y2. So first I consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y2. So I got the equation 3. Then I consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of the depth of flow y2. I got the equation 4. Then from equation 3 on the left side, take this y1 by 2 common. Take this y1 by 2 on the right side common in the equation 3. If I take this y1 by 2 common on this right side, the equation 3 becomes as, check this carefully, on the equation 2, on the equation 3 right side, take y1 by 2 common, then this equation 3 becomes as y2 is equal to y1 by 2 into minus 1, because it is minus y1 by 2. Take y1 by 2 common on the right side, then the equation 3 becomes as y2 is equal to y1 by 2 into minus 1 plus root of 1 square, that is 1, because it is y1 by 2 whole square. Take it outside, it is y1 by 2 into root 1 plus this term becomes as 8q square by z into y1 cube. So take this y1 by 2 in the three terms on the right side common. In the three terms on the right side, take this y1 by 2 common. This equation 3 becomes as y2 is equal to y1 by 2 into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by zy1 cube, that is this. So I consider the equation 3, and from that equation 3, I take out the y1 by 2 common on the right side only. So this equation 3, right hand side, becomes as y1 by 2 into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y1 cube. Bring that common y1 to the left side. Then this equation 3 becomes as y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y1 cube. So understand this equation 5 carefully. We got this equation 5 from equation 3. From equation 3, on the right side, I consider this y1 by 2 common first. So from this right side on equation 3, take y1 by 2 common. So this equation 3 becomes as y2 is equal to y1 by 2 into 1 minus y1 by 2 into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y1 cube. Then bring this y1 to the left side. The equation 3 becomes as y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z 3y1 cube, take it as equation 5. Similarly, from equation 4 on the right side, take y2 by 2 common. On the right side, we have three terms. From these three terms on the right side, take y2 by 2 common in the equation 4. The equation 4 becomes as y1 is equal to y2 by 2 into 1 minus, that is first term, y2 by 2 into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y2 cube. So in this equation 4 on the right side, take y2 by 2 common in the three terms. Then the right side becomes as y2 by 2 into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y2 cube. Bring that y2 from right side to left side. Then this equation 4 becomes as y1 by y2, that is from equation 4. y1 by y2 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y2 cube, that is equation 6. So from equation 2, I got the equation 3 and equation 4. By simplifying the equation 3, I got the equation 5. By simplifying the equation 4, I got the equation 6. Please go through these steps on the cell phone screens. If you have any doubts about this equation 3, 4, 5, 6, you please discuss with me. If you have any doubts about that equation 3, 4, 5, 6, you please discuss with me. Please give me the response. Is my voice audible to you clearly?
Sir.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Please go through that. Equation 3, we got it from equation 2. Please remember your lower classes. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 as the solution. X is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. I applied that solution here. The equation 2, we have this equation 2. First consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y2. So first term y2 square into y1. Take y1 as a. So it is a into y2 square plus second term y2 into y1 square. Take y1 square as b. So it is b into y2. First term a into y2 square plus second term b into y2. Bring this 2q square by z to the right side. It is minus 2q square by z equal to 0. Consider that minus 2q square by z as c. Consider this minus 2q square by z as c. This equation 2 becomes as a into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0. So here in the equation 2, y2 square into y1. y1 is a. So it is a into y2 square plus y2 into y1 square. y1 square is b. So it is b into y2. Take this 2q square by z to the right side. It is minus 2q square by z. Consider that minus 2q square by z as c. Then the equation 2 becomes as a into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0. That is the quadratic equation of depth y2. You know that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Quadratic equation solution, x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Apply that solution here. In place of x, we have y2. So it is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. So x is y2. y2 is equal to minus b. What is that b? y1 square minus b plus root of b square, that is y1 square whole square plus 4 into a. What is a? y1 into c. What is c? 2q square by z by 2a. Simplify that, you will get this equation 3. So from that relation, x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. I got that equation 3. So you have to do that. You have to do that simplification. I am giving the hint. So take that equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y2. A into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0. A is y1, b is y1 square, c is minus 2q square by z. Then apply the equation, x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. You will get that equation 3. Y2 is equal to minus y1 by 2 plus root of y1 by 2 whole square plus 2q square by z into y1. Similarly, you can consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of the depth y1. So in that case, the equation 2 is a into y1 square plus b into y1 plus c equal to 0. So a into y1 square, a is y2 plus b into y1, b is y2 square plus c minus 2q square by z equal to 0. Apply that solution, x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. You will get the equation 4. Y1 is equal to minus y2 by 2 plus root of y2 by 2 whole square plus 2q square by z to y2. So I got this equation 3 and 4 from the quadratic equation solution. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 has the solution. X is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So apply that solution for equation 2 by considering equation 2 as quadratic equation in terms of depth y2. You will get the equation 3. Then consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y1. You will get the equation 4. Then in the equation 3 on the right hand side, take that y1 by 2 common. On the right hand side in equation 3, take y1 by 2 common on the right side, then bring that y1 to the left side. You will get that equation 5. Y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y1. Similarly, in the equation 4 on the right side, take y2 by 2 common on the right side. Bring that y2 to the left side from equation 4. You will get that equation 6. Y1 by y2 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8q square by z into y2 cube. I am giving the equations. You practice these equations in the notebooks. Then only you can learn the concept. Practice these equations in the notebook. I am giving the hint. X is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. If you simplify that, you will get this equation 3. Similarly, x is equal to minus b plus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Simplify that, you will get equation 4. So do this as homework. I am not in a position to complete all the steps because I have a lot of syllabus. So it is your duty to do that homework at homes. Then only you will get the marks. So I am giving the procedure from equation 2 by considering the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y2. A into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0, you will get the equation 3. Similarly, take the equation 2 as the quadratic equation in terms of depth y1. A into y1 square plus b into y1 plus c equal to 0, you will get this equation 4. Then in the equation 3, take y1 by 2 common on the right side. Bring that y1 to the left side. You will get the equation 5. Similarly, in the equation 4, take y2 by 2 common on the right side. Bring that y2 to the left side. You will get this equation 6. You know that in the rectangular channels, in unit 1, I explained critical depth in rectangular channels. We discussed that critical depth in rectangular channels in unit 4, unit 1. So in that unit 1, in the rectangular channel critical depth, I explained in rectangular channel, the critical depth yc cube is equal to q square by z. I explained this derivation in unit 1, critical depth in rectangular channel. So at that time, in unit 1, I explained this relation. In the rectangular open channel, yc cube is equal to q square by z. Substitute this relation, because here also the channel is rectangular channel. We consider the rectangular channel and we assume the hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. In the rectangular channel, the critical depth of flow yc cube is equal to small q square by z. Then use that relation in the equation 5 and 6. Because in the equation 5, we have q square by z. In this square root, we have q square by z. But in the rectangular channel, q square by z is yc cube. Similarly, in the equation 6, we have this q square by z. In rectangular channel, q square by z is yc cube. So the equation 5, replace this q square by z as yc cube. And in the equation 6 also, replace this q square by z with yc cube. Then the equation 5 becomes as y2 by y1 is equal to same as equation 5. Only the thing is, in the equation 5, we have q square by z. I am converting that q square by z as yc cube. So the equation 5 becomes as y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into yc by y1 whole cube. This is from equation 5. In that equation 5, we convert this q square by z in this square root. Q square by z as yc cube. So it is 8 into yc cube by y1 cube. That is yc by y1 whole cube. That's the modification. Similarly, in the equation 6, q square by z as yc cube. So it is yc cube by y2 cube. So it is yc by y2 whole cube. So from equation 5, you will get equation 7. So y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into yc by y1 whole cube. And from equation 6, you got this equation 8. Y1 by y2 is equal to minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into yc by y2 whole cube. So from equation 5 and 6, I got the equation 7 and 8 just by modifying in the rectangular channel, q square by z is equal to yc cube. Carefully, we are discussing the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. We apply the specific force condition F1 is equal to F2. From that condition, we got the equation 2. First, we consider the equation 2 as quadratic equation in terms of the depth of flow y2, a into y2 square plus b into y2 plus c equal to 0. We got the equation 3. Then we consider the equation 2 as quadratic equation in terms of depth of flow y1, a into y1 square plus b into y1 plus c equal to 0. We got the equation 4. In the equation 3, right side, we consider y1 by 2 common. We got the equation 5. Then in the equation 4, we consider y2 by 2 as common on the right side. We got the equation 6. Then in the rectangular channel, q square by z, small q square by z is yc cube. We got the equation 7 from equation 5. So from equation 5, q square by z. So I consider q square by z is equal to yc cube. That is in the rectangular channel, the critical depth of flow yc cube is equal to q square by z. I substituted modification in the equation 5. I got the equation 7. Y2 by Y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into YC by Y1 whole cube. Similarly, from equation 6, I got the equation 8. Y1 by Y2 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into YC by Y2 whole cube. So up to this equation 8, understand this procedure. If you have doubts about this equation 8, you please ask me. Up to that equation 8, if you have any doubts in this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel, you please discuss with me up to that equation 8. Okay, now coming to the other modification. In open channels, we have one important dimensionless number, Prout's number. In open channels, in pipe flow, Reynolds number is important. Whereas in open channel, the Froude number is important. In open channel, the Froude number is defined as, the Froude number is equal to inertia force by gravitational force. That is the definition of Froude's number. So in open channels, the Froude number is defined as inertia force by gravity force. Then the equation of Froude number in open channels. The equation of Froude number in open channels is, we have two equations. Please listen everyone. The Froude number is represented as FR. In open channels, the Froude number has the equation FR is equal to V root CD. That is one equation. The equation of Froude number, FR is equal to V by root ZD. V is the mean velocity of flow. V is the hydraulic depth. Then in open channels, we have the another equation of Froude number. The other equation is Froude number in open channels, FR is equal to small q divided by root G into Y cube. That is another equation. The Froude number in open channels has two equations. First equation, in open channels, the Froude number FR is equal to V divided by root ZD. That is one equation. V is the mean velocity of flow. D is the hydraulic depth. Whereas the other equation of Froude number in open channels is, the Froude number FR is equal to V divided by root G into Y cube. FR is equal to small q, that is the discharge per unit width, small q divided by root g into y cube. Small q is the discharge per unit width, y is the depth of flow. That is the another equation of Froude number in open channels. FR is equal to small q divided by root g into y cube. Then in this hydraulic jump, at section 1, depth of flow is Y1. The discharge is capital Q, the width is B. And the discharge per unit width at section 1, small q is equal to capital Q by B. So the Froude number at section 1 in this hydraulic jump, FR1 is equal to small q divided by Y1 cube. This is the Froude number of hydraulic jump at section 1. Similarly, at section 2, depth of flow is Y2. Discharge per unit width is small q. So in this hydraulic jump at section 2, the Froude number FR2 is equal to q divided by root g into Y2 cube. So this is the Froude number equation in the open channels, especially in the rectangular channel. In the rectangular open channel, the Froude number FR is equal to small q divided by root g into y cube. This is the Froude number equation in the rectangular open channel. The Froude number is the important dimensionless number in open channels. The Froude number is the ratio between inertia force to gravitational force. In open channels, the Froude number has two equations. Fr is equal to V divided by root Zd. The mean velocity of flow, V is the hydraulic depth. Whereas the Froude number in rectangular channel is also given by Fr is equal to discharge per unit width small q divided by root g into y cube. That is the equation of Froude number in the rectangular open channel, small q divided by root g into y cube. Then in this hydraulic jump at section 1, the depth of flow is y1. At section 2, depth of flow is y2. So the Froude number at section 1, Fr1 is equal to small q divided by root g into y1 cube. At section 2, the Froude number Fr2 is equal to small q divided by root g into y2 cube. Substitute these equations. Substitute these equations in equation 3 and 4. Substitute them in the equations 3 and 4. So check that equation 3 and 4, please. So here in the equation 3, or in the equation, please, in the equation 5 and 6, please. In the equation 5, here we have q square by z into y1 cube. We know that q divided by root g into y1 cube is Fr1. We have q square by z into y1 cube. So this ratio is Fr1 square. Q square by z into y1 cube is Fr1 square. So the equation 5 in terms of the Froude number becomes as y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into Fr1 square. Because Fr1 square is equal to q square by z into y1 cube. So the equation 5 in terms of the Froude number Fr1 is written as y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into Fr1 square. Similarly, in the equation 6, we have this q square by z into y2 cube. We know that q divided by root g into y2 cube is Fr2, Froude number at section 2. But here it is q square by z into y2 cube, that is equal to Fr2 square. So in terms of the Froude number at section 2, the equation 6 becomes as y1 by y2 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into Fr2 square. So in terms of the Froude numbers Fr1 and Fr2, the equation 5 and 6 becomes as like this. In the equation 5, we have 8 into q square by z into y1 cube. Q square by z into y1 cube is Fr1 square. So the equation 5 changes as y2 by y1 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into Fr1 square. In the equation 6, we have q square by z into y2 cube. But q by root g into y2 cube is Fr2. So q square by z into y2 cube is Fr2 square. So the equation 6 becomes as y1 by y2 is equal to half into minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 into Fr2 square. So in this discussion, in this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel from equation 2, we got equation 3 and 4. Then from equation 3 and 4, we got 5 and 6. Then from 5 and 6, substituting q square by z as yc cube, we got 7 and 8. Then substituting the Froude's number in the equation 3 and 4, we got the equations. So these 10 equations, these 10 equations are the equations of hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. So in the today's class, I revised that hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. I started from the condition F1 is equal to F2. In the hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to the specific force at section 2. So we started this today's class, hydraulic jump in rectangular channel, from that condition F1 is equal to F2, that is equation 1. In that F1, A1 is equal to V into Y1, Z1 bar is equal to Y1 by 2, A2 is equal to V into Y2, Z2 bar is equal to Y2 by 2. Then we got the equation 2. We consider the equation 2 as quadratic equation. In terms of depth Y2, we got the equation 3. We consider the equation 2 as the quadratic equation. In terms of depth Y1, we got the equation 4. In the equation 3, on the right hand side, we consider Y1 by 2 as common. We got the equation 5. On the equation 4, right side, we consider Y2 by 2 common. We got the equation 6. Then in the equation 5, Q square by Z is equal to YC cube. We got the equation 7. Similarly, in the equation 6, we consider Q square by Z as YC cube. We got the. Then in the equation 3, we consider Q square by Z into Y1 cube as FR1 square, proud number FR1 square. We got the equation 1. In the equation 4, we consider Q square by Z into Y2 cube as FR2 square. We got the equation 10. So these 10 are the equations in hydraulic jump formed in rectangular open channels. So this is the discussion of hydraulic jump in the rectangular open channel from equation 1 to equation 10. What is equation 1? F1 is equal to F2. We got equation 2. From equation 2, we got 3 and 4. From 3 and 4, we got 5 and 6. Then we consider Q square by Z as YC cube in the rectangular channel. We got 7 and 8. Then by using the Froude number, we got 9 and 10. These equations are applicable to hydraulic jump in rectangular open channel. We have numerical problems on all these equations. So I will provide the material to you of this hydraulic jump. Please go through that material, practice these equations, that is important. Don't by heart the equations, because in the examinations, if you forgot that equation, you will be in the trouble. So try to practice them. I have given the entire procedure. X is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So practice them, dear students, practice them as your own. Don't neglect this hydraulic jump. To pass this hydraulic engineering, this hydraulic jump is very, very important. So I will provide this material of hydraulic jump. Go through that material, practice the equations, especially this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel from equation 1 to equation 10. If you have any doubts in this hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel, you please discuss with me. Any doubt, students, from equation 1 to equation 10 of this hydraulic jump in rectangular channel? If you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. Any doubts, students, up to this equation 10? you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. Is my voice audible to you? Is my voice audible to you? Give
yes,
me the
sir.
Response. Okay, thank you. So if you have any doubts in this hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel, you please discuss with me. Any doubts? Please give me the response. Please give me the response, whether you have doubts or no doubts. If you don't have doubts, at least post that. I hope at least some students are there in the class. Any doubts? Or no doubts, at least you have to pass that. Okay, now coming to the further concepts of hydraulic jump in the rectangular channel. Up to this equation 10, please follow this carefully. Up to this equation 10, we discuss the relationship between the depth of flow y1 and depth of flow y2. So up to this equation 10, we discuss the relationship between the depth of flow y1, depth of flow y2 for the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. So that is the discussion. From equation 1 to equation 10, we discuss the relationship between the depth of flow y1 and depth of flow y2 of the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. Dear students, we discuss already the hydraulic jump in the previous classes. We know that the hydraulic jump is formed when the supercritical water flow changes to subcritical water flow. When the water flow is changing from supercritical condition to subcritical condition, you will jump. In the supercritical condition, the water has more energy because the velocity of flow in the supercritical condition is large velocity. So in the supercritical condition, the water flow has large energy, whereas in the subcritical condition, the velocity is less. So the energy of water flow in the subcritical condition is lesser. So the water flow in hydraulic jump is changing from supercritical condition to subcritical condition. So the water flow in hydraulic jump is changing from higher energy at supercritical condition to lower energy at subcritical condition. Since that water is moving from higher energy to lower energy in hydraulic jump due to the turbulence, due to the rotatory motion in hydraulic jump, there is a loss in the energy of water flow. Now I am going to discuss with you how to calculate the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. So I am going to discuss with you now what is the equation to find out this loss of energy in the hydraulic jump in rectangular open channel. So please follow that determination of loss of energy. So check that equation carefully. So please everyone look that diagram on the cell phones. The expression for loss of energy in hydraulic jump, I am going to explain how to calculate the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. This is that hydraulic jump. before the hydraulic jump, the flow is in supercritical condition, large energy. After the hydraulic jump, the flow is in subcritical condition, less energy. So the flow is changing from higher energy to lower energy, because in this hydraulic jump, we have the loss of energy. This is a turbulent flow, rotatory flow. So there is a loss of energy of water flow in this hydraulic jump. We are going to discuss how to determine that loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. What is the equation? So I am going to discuss with you the expression for loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. For that, consider this diagram. So far we discussed this diagram number of times. I explained this diagram. Before the hydraulic jump, we consider the section 1. This section 1 is in the supercritical condition. The depth of flow at section 1 is y1, velocity of flow is v1, discharge is q1, hydrostatic force is f1. Then we consider the section 2 after the hydraulic jump in the subcritical condition. At section 2, depth of flow is y2, velocity of flow is v2, discharge is q, hydrostatic force is f2. We know that in hydraulic jump, the specific force at section 1 is equal to specific force at section 2. Y1 is called initial depth, Y2 is called sequent depth, Y1, Y2 are called the conjugative depths. Then in this diagram, the weight component of water flow, water weight is W sin theta, the friction force at the channel bottom is FF. So number of times we discussed this diagram in the previous classes. By using these diagrams, I am going to explain what is the equation for the loss of energy in the hydraulic jump. So coming to this discussion, read these points carefully. To understand the equation of the loss of energy in that hydraulic jump, please everyone read those steps in the cell phone screens. Consider the hydraulic jump formed in the rectangular channel. So here we consider the channel as a rectangular channel. So please everyone read those steps on the cell phone screens carefully. You can understand this concept if you read these steps carefully. We are going to discuss the equation for loss of energy in the hydraulic jump. So I consider the hydraulic jump formed in the rectangular channel. Let y1 is the depth of flow. Y1 is the depth of flow in the rectangular channel. That is before the hydraulic jump at section 1. Y2 is the depth of flow in the rectangular channel after the hydraulic jump. Y1 is supercritical water flow. Y2 is the subcritical water flow. Y1 is called the initial depth. Y2 is called the sequent depth. Y1, Y2 are called the conjugative depths. V is the width of the rectangular channel. And Q is the discharge of water flow from section 1 to section 2. Small w is the unit weight of water. So go through these points on the screen. Go through these points. Y1 is the depth of water flow before the hydraulic jump, that is called supercritical water flow. Y2 is the depth of water flow after the hydraulic jump, that is called the subcritical water flow. Y1 is called the initial depth. Y2 is called the sequent depth. Y1, Y2 are called the conjugative depths. V is the width of the rectangular channel bottom. Of water flow from section 1 to section 2. W is the unit weight of water in that hydraulic jump. Then at section 1, V1 is the velocity. So V1 is the velocity of supercritical water flow. V2 is the velocity of subcritical water flow. Then the discharge per unit width, small q. The discharge per unit width, small q, is equal to capital Q by V. The discharge per unit width, small q, capital V by V, capital Q by V. Since the channel is a rectangular channel at section 1, that is before the hydraulic jump at section 1, the wetted area A1 is equal to V into Y1. V is the channel bottom width, Y1 is the depth of flow. at section 1, that is before the hydraulic jump. So before the hydraulic jump, the wetted area B into Y1. After the hydraulic jump, the wetted area B into Y2. We know that in the today's class, I explained the equation 2. Please remember, we got that equation 2 from this equation. We got that equation 2. Today's class, I explained. From equation 2, in the today's class, we discussed this. 2q square t is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. If I expand this right hand side, I got 2q square by z is equal to y1 into y2 square plus y2 into y1 square. That is equation 2. We discussed that equation 2 in the today's class. In order to prepare the equation, for loss of energy in the hydraulic jump, I consider that equation 2. According to equation 2, in the rectangular channel, 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y1 plus y2. In the today's class, we discussed that relation, that is equation 2. I am explaining this loss of energy in the hydraulic jump from that equation 2. So please everyone follow this derivation of equation loss of energy in the hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. We know that in rectangular channel hydraulic jump, 2q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1. From this equation, q square by z is equal to, from this equation, take this 2 to the right side. This equation becomes as q square by z is equal to y1 by 2 into y2 plus y1 by 2. Take this as equation 1. So we are going to discuss the derivation of equation for the loss of energy in hydraulic jump from this equation 2. I modify this equation 2, and from that I got this relation q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1 by 2. In this loss of energy, take this equation as 1. Actually, this is equation 2. We got this equation 2 from the specific force condition F1 is equal to F2. Already we discussed this equation in the previous discussion. In today's class, we discussed this equation just 10 minutes before. Then from that equation 2, I got this equation 1. This equation 1 for the loss of energy of hydraulic jump in rectangular channel. So q square by z is equal to y1 y2 into y2 plus y1 divided by 2. Now coming to the specific energy. We know the specific energy very well. In the unit 1, I explained the specific energy of water flow. In open channels, the specific energy E is equal to the sum of pressure head Y plus kinetic head V square by 2Z. That is called the specific energy of water flow in open channels, Y plus V square by 2Z. Y is called the pressure head, that is depth of flow. V square by 2Z is called the kinetic head. The sum of pressure head and kinetic head is called the specific energy of water flow in open channel, that is E. We discussed the specific energy in unit 1. The specific energy of water flow E is equal to Y plus V square by 2Z. Then in this hydraulic jump at section 1, the depth of water flow is Y1. Velocity of water flow is V1. Specific energy of water flow at section 1. We know that at section 1, the water flow is supercritical condition. At section 1, the water flow in the hydraulic jump is supercritical condition. So the specific energy of water flow at section 1 in the supercritical condition E1 is equal to Y1 plus V1 square by 2Z. This is the specific energy at section 1 before the hydraulic jump, y1 plus v1 square by 2z. Velocity v1 is equal to discharge q divided by wetted area a1. So I can write this v1 as 2 by a1. So slightly modify this first second term. Velocity v1 is equal to q by a1. So this e1 is equal to y1. This is the pressure head, depth of flow y1 plus q square by 2z into a1 square, because it is v1 square. V1 square is equal to q square by a1 square. Since the channel is rectangular channel, this wetted area a1 is equal to v into y1. Since the channel is rectangular channel, the wetted area a1 is equal to v into y1. So a1 square is equal to v square into y1 square. Then capital q square by capital b square, q by b is small q. So q square by b square is small q square. So follow this E1 equation. Follow this E1 equation. E1 is the specific energy of water flow at section 1 before the hydraulic jump in the supercritical condition. Actually, E1 is equal to y1 plus v1 square by 2z. It is the sum of the pressure head, that is the depth of flow y1, plus the kinetic head v1 square by 2z. That is the specific energy. So e1 is equal to y1 plus v1 square by 2z, but v1 is equal to q by area a1. So e1 is equal to y1 plus q square by 2z a1 square. A1 is equal to b into y1, because it is rectangular channel. Wetted area a1 is equal to b into y1, so a1 square is b square into y1 square, but capital q square by b square is small q square. So at section 1, in the supercritical condition, the specific energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump e1 is equal to y1 plus q square by 2z into y1 square. Then read this entire derivation. If you have any doubts about this energy e1, you please ask me. Please go through that entire derivation. If you have doubts, you please ask me. Okay, then coming to the section 2. After the hydraulic jump. Section 2 is after the hydraulic jump. Section 2 is in subcritical condition. At section 2, the pressure head, that is the depth of flow, is y2. At section 2, the velocity is v2. So at section 2, the kinetic head is v2 square by 2z. So at section 2, in the subcritical condition, the specific energy of water flow E2 is equal to, this is the specific energy of water flow at section 2 after the hydraulic jump in subcritical condition. E2 is equal to y2 plus v2 square by 2z. y2 is the depth of water flow or the pressure head. v2 square by 2z is the kinetic head. So at section 2, the specific energy of water flow E2 is equal to y2 plus v2 square by 2z. The velocity v2 is equal to discharge by wetted area a2. So v2 is equal to q by a2 square. So e2 is equal to y2 plus q square by 2z a2 square. Since it is a rectangular channel, wetted area a2 is equal to width b into depth of flow y2. So a2 square is equal to b2 into y2 square, q small q square. So at section 2, after the hydraulic jump in the subcritical condition, the specific energy of water flow e2 is equal to y2 plus q square by 2z into y2 square. So this is the specific energy before the hydraulic jump in the supercritical condition. This is the specific energy after the hydraulic jump in the subcritical condition. Check these two equations of E1, E2. If you have any doubts about this equation of E1 or the equation of E2, E1 is the specific energy before the hydraulic jump in the supercritical condition. E2 is the specific energy after the hydraulic jump in the subcritical condition. This E1 is always more than E2. because E1 is in the supercritical condition, E2 is in the subcritical condition, E1 is more than E2. So there is a loss in the energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. Is the loss of energy in the hydraulic jump, that delta E is equal to E1 minus E2. E1 is the specific energy of water flow before the hydraulic jump in the supercritical condition. This is the equation. E2 is the specific energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump, after the hydraulic jump in the subcritical condition. This is the equation of E2. So in that hydraulic jump, the loss of energy of water flow, delta E is equal to E1 minus E2. So read these steps in the cell phone screens. Understand this equation of the loss of energy in the hydraulic jump. The loss of energy in the hydraulic jump is E1 minus E2. Hydraulic jump is a turbulent flow, highly rotated flow. So the water flow in the hydraulic jump loses the energy. Since the water flow is moving from supercritical condition to subcritical condition through this hydraulic jump, there is a loss of water flow in the hydraulic jump, that is given by delta E. Delta E is equal to E1 minus E2. Please read these steps on the cell phone screens. If you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. Any doubt, students, up to that delta E, only Pawan Kalyan is responding. Remaining students, I don't know whether you are there in the class or you are in some other works. If you are there in the class, you please respond. From the past 1.5 hour, I am taking this class for you. For your benefits, I am taking this class. So at least give me the response. If you have any doubts, you please discuss with me. Otherwise, if you don't have doubts, at least give me that response. Okay, in the tomorrow class, I will explain what is this equation of delta E. Just by substituting E1 from this, E1 is equal to Y1 plus 2 square by 2Z Y1 square. E2 is equal to Y2 plus 2 square by 2Z Y2 square. By substituting E1 and E2 from these equations, you will get the expression for the loss of energy delta E. Tomorrow class, I will explain this derivation of delta E, the loss of energy of water flow in the hydraulic jump. In the next class, I will explain that loss of energy equation of hydraulic jump. So with this, I am going to stop the today's class. You please move on to the next class. If anybody is having doubts, you please discuss with me. Otherwise, you can go to the next class.